Kaspersky just released a free antivirus product for everyone. Forgive me if I'm not too excited though, because this is basically the same product which has been released in Russia and some other countries earlier, and now they just made it available elsewhere in English. Also, it doesn't seem to possess any of the important components like System Watcher, Application Control, which are present in the Kaspersky Internet Security and Pure Total Protection suites. So, I'm not overly optimistic about this product. It seems very simplistic. It has the cloud protection, though. That's nice. And you do get your basic signatures. Now, Kaspersky signatures are pretty good, and I think it's nice to have this option to run Kaspersky signatures on your system for free. But at the same time, I do not feel very confident recommending this product as complete protection. And neither does Kaspersky want me to, I guess. But anyway, I've grabbed a few malware links and I'm gonna test these out and we'll see what happens. Of course, this is not going to be a really intensive test like I usually do. I don't have any malware samples or zero-day threats, but I doubt if there's much of a point in doing that since this product is very basic. So let's just see if it at least functions as it should and gives you that basic protection. First link is blocked as malicious. I like the alert system, very clean, organized and informative. The second link also seems to have been taken care of. Let's keep going. And again, blocked by Kaspersky. Those signatures are good. What did I tell you? This one's taken care of as well. Trust me, I got these links this very morning from VXVault mostly. So they are fresh malware. And I also checked that they're all active and delivering their payloads. So if not for Kaspersky, we would have probably had a couple of threats sneak in by now. But so far so good. Everything has been blocked. A few more links to go. I also like the speed of detection. For some reason, I always feel that Bitdefender slows down the navigation process when something like this happens. But Kaspersky seems very quick to respond. This is weird. I was not getting this pop-up earlier. Maybe the malicious file has been removed. But the last link is also blocked. So that's a really good job by Kaspersky. Everything was blocked using the URL filter and nothing even made it onto the system. However, I'm just going to reiterate that this is still very basic. Most of the advanced components are not available. So if you're just looking for some kind of signature-based scanner to run on your system for whatever reason, that's quite a bit better than Windows Defender. This is probably a good choice. If you want to run it along with another product, I don't know if they support that officially, but I think you can do it. And that would be another nice layer of signatures. But here's my major issue with products like this. The use case for them is really vanishing at this point. There are better free AV programs that give you more protection. Now, for example, like as much as I hate the practices of some of the free AV vendors, they would still protect you better than this thing in some cases. And also it's direct competition. Bitdefender Free is also, I think, a bit better because they give you the behavior blocker or active virus control along with their signature. So I'm not terribly excited, but I thought you guys should know, so I made this really quick review. Let me know your thoughts on Kaspersky Free Antivirus, and if I'm wrong, and if it does have some kind of zero-day protection, and some of you find out, let me know in the comments, and maybe I'll take a more detailed look at it. But for now, this is what I'm guessing is the entirety of the product, so I didn't push it too much. So my final view on this is that as much as I like the aesthetics, the UI, and the Kaspersky signatures, their web filter, I still don't feel like I have a solid use case for a product like this. If you want to go with Kaspersky, I would recommend going for at least the internet security version. Or if you have your mindset on using this, then, you know, do consider adding something else that'll give you some kind of behavioral blocking, or maybe just add in another free product in there. Those are just my thoughts. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Please like and share if you did. This is Leo from the PC Security Channel. Thank you for watching, and as always, stay informed, stay secure.